Hey guys, welcome back to another episode. In this video we will be going through our very simple, yet profitable price action trading strategy. If you want more videos more often, please smash the like button, subscribe, and turn on the notifications bell, and share this video across your WhatsApp, Facebook accounts, or Twitter to show your support. A very important point before we start. Everything we discuss in this video can be used for currency trading, stock trading, and crypto, because price action stays relatively consistent across different assets, so we're going to go very in-depth in this video. Top 6 most powerful price action candlestick patterns every trader must know. The trader can use a market's price action to describe the human thought process behind a market's movement. Every participant in a market will leave price action clues on a market's price chart as they trade their markets. These clues can then be interpreted and used to try and predict the next move in a market. So, these are the top 6 most powerful price action candlestick patterns you must know. First, dark cloud cover and piercing line. The dark cloud cover. What is dark cloud cover? The dark cloud cover pattern is a candlestick pattern that signals a potential reversal to the downside. It appears at the top of an uptrend and involves a large bullish candle, followed by a bearish candle that creates a new high, before closing lower than the midway point of the previous bullish candle. The dark cloud cover is important to note as a potential bearish indicator, especially if it forms on a higher time frame chart, such as a daily chart. On lower time frames, its significance is considerably reduced. The 5 criteria for the dark cloud cover pattern are: first, an existing bullish uptrend. Second, an up or bullish candle within that uptrend. Third, a gap up on the following day. Fourth, the gap up turns into a down or bearish candle. Fifth, the bearish candle closes below the midpoint of the previous bullish candle. So, here are the rules for entering a short position using Bollinger Band's indicator. The recommended time frame for this strategy is the daily chart. First, an uptrend must be clearly present on the price chart. Second, the dark cloud cover formation must be present. Third, the second bar within the dark cloud cover must be outside the upper Bollinger Band line. Fourth, enter a sell order at the break and close of the low of the second candle within the dark cloud cover. Fifth, the stop loss should be placed above the high of the second bar of the dark cloud cover formation. Sixth, the exit will occur when one of these conditions is met: the price crosses below the Bollinger Band center line and then closes above it, or the price touches the lower Bollinger Band line. Whichever condition occurs first will trigger the exit. The piercing line pattern. What is a piercing pattern? The piercing pattern is a candlestick pattern that signals a potential reversal to the upside. It appears at the bottom of a downtrend and involves a large bearish candle, followed by a bullish candle that creates a new high, before closing higher than the midway point of the previous bearish candle. The piercing pattern is important to note as a potential bullish indicator, especially if it forms on a higher time frame chart, such as a daily chart. On lower time frames, its significance is considerably reduced. The 5 criteria for the piercing pattern are: first, an existing bearish downtrend. Second, a down or bearish candle within that downtrend. Third, a gap down on the following day. Fourth, the gap down turns into a bullish candle. Fifth, the bullish candle closes above the midpoint of the previous bearish candle. Traders evaluate the significance of the piercing pattern as a bullish signal by the following factors. First, the bodies of both the initial candle and the piercing candle are very long. Second, the lower the opening gap down by the piercing candle, the more marked the reversal upward. Third, the pattern occurs near a major support level, especially if the gap down is over the support level, but the candle's eventual close is above the support level. So, here are other examples of dark cloud cover and piercing line trading strategy. Second, bullish and bearish engulfing. Bullish engulfing candlestick pattern. The bullish engulfing pattern is a technical chart pattern that signals higher prices to come. The pattern consists of a down candlestick followed by a large up candlestick that eclipses or engulfs the smaller down candle. The pattern can be important because it shows buyers have overtaken the sellers and are pushing the price more aggressively up than the sellers were able to push it down. The pattern has greater reliability when the open price of the engulfing candle is well below the close of the first candle and when the close of the engulfing candle is well above the open of the first candle. A much larger up candle shows more strength than if the up candle is only slightly larger than the down candle. How do we trade it? Before acting on the pattern, traders typically wait for the second candle to close and then take action on the following candle. Actions include buying a short position once a bullish engulfing pattern occurs or potentially entering a long position. If entering a new long position, a stop loss can be placed below the low of the 2-bar pattern. Bearish engulfing candlestick pattern. The bearish engulfing pattern is a technical chart pattern that signals lower prices to come. The pattern consists of an up candlestick followed by a large down candlestick that eclipses or engulfs the smaller up candle. The pattern can be important because it shows sellers have overtaken the buyers and are pushing the price more aggressively down than the buyers were able to push it up. The pattern has greater reliability when the open price of the engulfing candle is well above the close of the first candle and when the close of the engulfing candle is well below the open of the first candle. A much larger down candle shows more strength than if the down candle is only slightly larger than the up candle. How do we trade it? Before acting on the pattern, traders typically wait for the second candle to close and then take action on the following candle. Actions include selling a long position once a bearish engulfing pattern occurs, or potentially entering a short position. If entering a new short position, a stop loss can be placed above the high of the 2-bar pattern. And now, here are other examples of bullish and bearish engulfing trading strategy. Third, Pinocchio bar or pin bar. The pin bar pattern consists of one price bar, typically a candlestick price bar, which represents a sharp reversal and rejection of price. Pin bar candle must have the following features. Tail, also known as wick or shadow. The pin bar is a candle with a long upper or lower tail. That is the highlight of a pin bar that shows a strong rejection of prices. The pin bar tail must be at least 2/3 of the length of the candlestick bar. Longer tails on a pin bar indicate a more significant reversal and rejection of price. Thus, long-tailed pin bars tend to be a little higher probability than their shorter-tailed counterparts. Body. This is the zone between the opening and closing prices. The body of a candlestick must not be longer than 1/3 of the length of the candlestick bar. The opening and closing prices of adjacent bars are close to each other or may be equal. Pin bar nose. This is the opposite of the tail. A pin bar does not necessarily have a nose. Sometimes, the pin bar doesn't have a nose because it opens and closes right at the closing price of the candle. The smaller the pin bar nose is, the better it becomes. How do we trade Pinocchio bar? Bullish pin bar. The valid tradable bullish pin bar is located at the end of a bearish trend, and its lower candle wick goes below the overall price action. If you spot a bullish pin bar setup on the chart, this will set up a nice opportunity for a long position. When trading bullish pin bars, you always need to put your stop loss a few pips below the low of the pin. Bearish pin bar. The bearish pin bar is located at the end of a bullish trend, and its longer candle wick is the upper area. In this manner, the longer wick is sticking out above the price action. The bearish pin bar is usually a good sign of an upcoming price reversal in the bearish direction. With bearish pin bars, your stop loss always needs to be placed just above the high of the pin. Here are other examples of Pinocchio bar trading strategy. Fourth, inside bar. What is an inside bar? The inside bar is a popular reversal or continuation candle formation that only requires two candles to present itself. This pattern is a direct play on short-term market sentiment looking to enter before the big moves that may take place in the market. The inside bar shows a reluctance of prices to progress above or below the preceding candle high and low, indicating market indecision. Here are the examples of inside bar trading strategy. Outside bar. What is an outside bar candlestick pattern? Like all other types of candlestick patterns, an outside bar candlestick pattern is a price action indicator, or pattern, used to predict price movement in the forex and stock market. Outside bar candlesticks are recognized when the outside bar overshadows or engulfs the inside bar. When the outside bar candlestick forms, it indicates that the prevailing mindset and beliefs of investors have changed over the course of the day. Here are the examples of outside bar trading strategy. Sixth, fakie pattern, or inside bar false breakout. The fakie pattern can best be described as a false breakout from an inside bar pattern. The fakie pattern always starts with an inside bar pattern. When price initially breaks out from the inside bar pattern but then quickly reverses, creating a false break, and closes back within the range of the mother bar, or inside bar, we have a fakie pattern. So, think of it like this. Inside bar plus false breakout equals fakie pattern. Fakies are a very important and potent price action trading strategy because they can help us identify stop hunting by the big boys and provide us with a very good clue as to what price might do next. How to trade with fakie patterns. The most common entries for a fakie signal include the following. Enter as price breaks back past the inside bar or mother bar low or high following the initial false break. This can be an on-stop entry or an at-market entry. If the fakie pattern has a pin bar, you can use a pin bar trade entry. Here are the examples of fakie patterns trading strategy. Final word. A trader can use a market's price action to describe the human thought process behind a market's movement. Every participant in a market will leave price action clues on a market's price chart as they trade their markets. These clues can then be interpreted and used to try and predict the next move in a market. As always, if you learned something new, or if you want more videos more often, make sure you subscribe, click the notification bell, and share this video across your WhatsApp, Facebook accounts, or Twitter to show your support. See you next time.